Oh, I'm only 4 minutes late today. Not too bad. Not that anyone's paying attention. Google glasses are on the ground. Google glasses. So Google. Probably have like a little hidden microchip or something in it. Reads your mind. Google. I'm so Google right now.
I'm so Google. My Google. My Google.
I was late because I had to fashion a pot pipe. Look at this thing. Look at this thing. Look at this sheer work of genius. It's a piece of metal, like a little fucking thingamabobber, like a little, you know, like a hydro, like one of them fucking pneumatic tool, you know, those air powered tools. It's like, I think it's a little bit that on the end of the hose, like whatever that fits into the hose thing. You know what I'm saying? NLOTB's in the house. Right on, brother. Nice to see you. You are a man, aren't you? Are you a woman? I can't tell. No longer on the ball? Well, could be either or. I just think that you're a guy, but you tell me. Oh, no, I've seen you on shows before. Yeah, never mind. I know you're a guy. Sorry, my bad. Sorry about that. So look at my pipe. Look at this, this fucking pneumatic little fitting. And then there's a little hose, little thing that I cut off. And look at this sucker right there. Now I can smoke my pot. Yipper. Because my bong tipped over on our bed last night. It was a fucking disaster. I was so pissed. Oh, God. Yeah, I remember. I'm sorry. I've seen you on people's shows and stuff.
I know. I forgot.
I'm honored to have you in here. Thank you. Thank you for coming. What did I? Oh yeah, I titled my show Algorithmic Gimmick. I've been laughing about this shit with fucking AI. Excuse me. My friend showed me this video of these guys that are going around. They were doing this conference. This is like maybe a year or two ago when these guys were doing their tour, but they were talking about AI and the dangers of it, or just like more just trying to educate people about it and show and whatever. And they weren't exactly like, they're not AI fanatics, you know, they weren't like excited about it, but they're excited to tell people about the, about how to, you know, deal with it. Cause I mean, they weren't necessarily trying to stop it. They did say in their lecture that they wish, if they could have their way, they wouldn't, they didn't want AI, but since it's already happening, they're just going around educating people about it. But they had these videos they were showing, this one thing was, it's like, it's funny because like a critical thinker has to watch it. And I mean, and tell me what you think. I mean, they had this thing where there was a person, you know, in a room, and they would show the person a picture. Maybe you've seen this already, a picture. And then the AI, you know, is, basically has to read the kid's mind or the person or whatever that's standing there and see what, and give you know, a representation of what the AI thinks the person is thinking about or whatever. So it just by scanning his head or whatever. So the kid looks at a picture of a giraffe and then the AI pulls up a picture of a giraffe. It's like, oh my God, look at them. I'm like, well, dude, it's just like, does anybody bother to think like, well, maybe they just told the computer to pull up a picture of a giraffe. I mean, how hard is it to make that fucking thing, make that like demonstration? It's just kind of sad, you know? It's like how do we know that it's not just being, because that's what, like, there's been cases of this kind of shit happening already. There's like, I think it's, I mean, recently Amazon, you know, the place where you can just go in and leave or whatever without, it's like the place where you can pretend you're just like shoplifting, but they actually charge you for everything, you know? What's it called? Amazon, whatever, cashierless Amazon or whatever. You don't have to pay. You just go grab stuff and leave, and then fucking seize you and it fucking takes money out of your account or whatever. I guess they recently, something happened with that, but it's where it was like, they're not really, it's supposed to be all like operated by AI, you know, where it's all like, you know, computer learning, what a computer fucking operated shit. But it turns out it was just like like 1500, I forget how many it was. It was like over 1,000 people, employees in India that were just watching various stores. It wasn't AI at all. It was just actual people that were watching and trying to keep up on it. I don't know how this all came to light. I forget. I just saw the story. I'm like, wait, so it wasn't AI. It was fucking just people in India looking at a computer screen. That's pretty funny. Yeah, bong water is the worst, man. It stinks. I was pissed. My girlfriend is such a fucking trooper, dude. She got up and fucking, I was all, fuck, I don't even want to sleep in the bed now. And she gets up and fucking changes the sheets. You know, she's all like super sweet and like, oh, it's okay, I got it. Gets everything all changed out, all the pillowcases, sprays the stuff on the floor, makes it smell go away, you know. And I was still being a bitch about it. I'm like, I want to sleep on this side of the bed. I have a really sensitive smell. And I can smell shit that she can't smell. You know, it's like I have a girlfriend that has a bad sense of smell. Fortunately, she smells great. And fortunately, she can't smell me. This is terrific. Oh, man. But yeah, she is a sweetheart, man. She cleaned up all that shit. I couldn't believe it, man. I was just like pissed, too. It was my fault. I was mad at myself. I wasn't mad at her or anything. She really knew how to deal with the issue. Bong water is a nightmare. It smells so bad. I don't know what I was thinking putting a bong next to the bed. It's fucking stupid. I do dumb things, then I yell. Hey, I know what AI is. AI is just 1,000 guys in India looking at computer screens. Bunch of nerds hired everywhere just to fucking, you know, answer questions and chat GPT or whatever. It's just a bunch of people sitting behind computers. It's like, this is so interesting. I get a different answer every time. And it's always really like, it seems like it's coming from a person. Yeah, because it is. This AI, what if it's just a big hoax? Wouldn't that be funny? Oh, we made this robot that looks like it's teaching. We programmed it to look like it's teaching itself. Okay, we admit it. It's not really teaching itself. They want so badly to be able to, like, imitate, to be God. You know what I mean? It's like, that's what it boils down to. They're just like, they want so badly to be able to create, you know, a thing that has a will of its own. You know, like, that's sentient without having to, you know, actually just create life the old-fashioned way, which is what I prefer the old-fashioned way. It's a lot more fun, and it's just like, it feels good, and it looks good, and it's great. Why would you want to improve on that? I mean, what the fuck is wrong with people, man? We need to make a synthetic, we need to make those skin jobs. We're either going to live in Blade Runner or The Matrix, and one or the other, and one, maybe one first, and then leads to the other. But in any case, I prefer the old-fashioned way of making people, and I also prefer real people. I don't want to have cyborgs. You have to, like, decide who's a cyborg, who's not. It's already weird enough with the fucking LGBT que fucking whatever letters. AI plus. Now they're going to add another one. Now they're going to add, like, they're going to add the pedos to their shit. That's what I heard. Am I not supposed to say that on YouTube? Oh, yeah. Fuck YouTube. Not you, but YouTube. You know what I mean. Because if you say something that YouTube don't like, well, they come along and give you a strike. Talking about something they're trying to hide is gonna get your tubes tied up right. They don't like that shit one bit. Whoa, I don't like that shit. Well, that was a D string. I'm off to a great start, aren't I? Shite. Just fuck. Fuck me. Do I have any strings out here? That'd be fucking. Yeah, there I do. Look, I do. I'm one prepared motherfucker. If you said something that YouTube don't like, will they come along and give you a strike? You were talking about something that they want to hide.
It's gonna get your tubes tied up right quick.
They don't like that shit. One bit. I don't have a D-string out here. You're gonna have to come with me into my room where I can find the proper string to fix this thing with. I can't believe I already broke a string. This is fucking crap. What a crappy show this is. I'm going home. I take my ball and go home. Do I sound like a Glober? I'm taking my ball. I'm going home. You guys suck. Screw you guys. You don't want to just believe people when they say things. You want to see proof of everything.
Why don't you prove the earth is flat and stationary? Why don't you go prove the objective reality we've all, the only thing we've ever known? I mean, does it really, it must keep these guys up late at night. That's why they come to our shows. They get so pissed. They're like, fuck. They're right. They're like, we do have to treat this place like it's a level stationary plane. It must really eat them up. They actually, at the end of the day, they got to treat the place like it's what they're telling us we're stupid for saying it is. That must really eat those guys up. They're losing sleep over. That's why they're fucking trolling the, you know, late night fucking Flat Earth Fridays. Do you ever go to that show? I love that show. Flat Earth Friday went all the way into Saturday night. Those guys are such diehards, man. I love it. Shout out to Flat Earth Friday. What channel is that? I think it's on Ether Cosmology. But there's also the Space Audits. Ether Cosmology and Space Audits. I forget their name. Alan is one of the guys. What's the other? You know what I'm talking about? What's the other guy's name? Alan and... Darn it. Maybe one of you know. Okay, I'm looking for a D string. But yeah, Globers, they're funny people. They're really, they need some help. We're trying to help them. That's the thing that's really funny about the whole thing. It's like, hello, we're just trying to help you out. I mean, Jaron put it so eloquently one time. He's just like, I got into this. I figured like people were going to be excited and just want, you know, be like amazed like I was. And, you know, it's like, I'm just trying to help people. I just want to, like, I figured if you were like being fucking hoaxed and if you were like being duped, you'd want to fucking know. It's not me that's duping you. I'm just, hey, dude, check it out. We've all been fooled. No, we haven't. Space is so real. I've seen it on TV. No, but think about it. Just because, like, if you only seen it on TV, it could be fake, right? No, because my uncle worked for fucking... He made the Hubble telescope. That's actually my uncle. My uncle did work for whoever that fucking made the Hubble. He helped design the fucking thing. I just don't like admitting that, people, because then space is real. No, because that just proves my uncle's an idiot. I mean, wasn't that the one that had to like fucking go and like put the lens on backwards or something? Shane, that's the guy's name. Yeah, shout out to those guys. I love those guys. I thought it was super cool that they spotted me and gave me a wrench right away because I've been in this for a while. You know, they know I'm not going to fucking, that I'm right quick to fucking argue with people that come into the chat too and then fucking start talking shit. I'm not quiet about it. I'm just fucking, someone's going to come into the chat on a Flat Earth show and act like a complete idiot. I might try to help them a little bit if it seems like they're genuine people, which would be like, oh man, there's a lot more to this. Like, just hold tight. Just, you know, just listen. Don't, you know, if you got some, we'll answer all your questions. Trust me. We've been through this, you know, we've been at this for a while. We're just people like you, you know, it's like all the questions you have, we had those too, you know, just hang in there, hold on, you know, let us tell you all this stuff. I mean, there's a lot of stuff, dude, but it's like, you know, if you just shut up for a second, you know, it's like, just listen to the information. It's interesting. I mean, fucking, you might decide that you don't agree or something, but like, the thing is, I mean, if you're just being honest, it's like, you really don't know if Earth is a globe. You just got to be honest. Nobody could know because we'd have to leave the Earth to find that out. And it turns out it's pretty fucking hard to figure that out from the Earth. And yeah, it's impossible to figure that out, in fact. And it just so happens they've designed their model to be fucking impossible to prove wrong. It's like fucking unfalsifiable, which is pseudoscience by definition. Sorry about your luck, buddy. It's like, well, look, we can see too far. No, that's just because the refraction makes things bend up and look exactly how it would look if the Earth was flat. Look, we can't feel the Earth moving. No, that's just because it's spinning and it's so steady and so constant, and it's just such a big, vast, you know, it's so big and all this stuff, and that it's just, that it feels like it's just like it would be if it was stationary. Okay. You know, it's like you get answers like that, and after a while, you're like, so the sun is 93 million miles away. How did they figure that out? Oh, well, they aimed some radar at it, and then the radar bounced off and came back, and it was like 93 million miles. Whoa, that's cool. Did you see him do that? No, but they said they did. And like, well, I'm just curious, what kind of transmitter? I mean, 93 times two. That's like, you know, it's like a quarter billion miles we're talking. That's a pretty good transmitter. And I mean, what? So when you point radar at a light, it doesn't bounce off of it. So I guess the sun isn't a light. So how did that work? I want to see that work. Well, they had this, you know, there's some proof somewhere. You just got to trust us. Funny how all the globe things come down to one thing. You got to trust us. Either that or the proof is, we know Earth is a sphere, so of course it works. We don't know how it works, but obviously it does, because Earth is a sphere. It's like the three-body problem. It's like, we couldn't figure out how to you know, animate it or simulate it with the computer. I mean, the computer couldn't figure it out. AI just, you know, it was basically like, no, this doesn't work. And so, you know, we just don't know yet, but we know that it's working, obviously, because we can see it, you know, but it's like, but we just, you know, we just can't explain it with our shit. Three body problem. And that's just three of them. And there's supposed to be all these other bodies with bodies and fucking, you know, give me a break. It starts to sound like a fucking joke after a while, if you really pay attention to it and get good and stoned and go into it nice and stoned. But if you're like a person that's like invested in that crap and you're like a fucking scientist or a teacher or something, it's kind of like kicking sand in your face, you know? It's like, it's kind of like, that's when it starts to become sort of fucking irritating for people if they're invested in it somehow, you know? My uncle probably wouldn't want to hear me talking about flat Earth. He'd be like, I can just imagine how that would go over, you know? Because he's worked, you know, he helped build the telescope. That they fucking sent to space and realized they had the wrong lens on it or something. Didn't take the lens cap off. Those brilliant guys. You know, it's like, I love those little stories like that. It's like Russia sent these fucking, this is something that nobody ever talks about, but Russia sent these fucking little like spaceships to planet Venus in the 70s. Russia had, you know, I don't know why nobody talks about that, but it's fucking funny. It's a crazy story because they sent a bunch of them there. They sent one all the way to Venus, and then, sorry, I'm laughing so much. I just, shit cracks me up, dude. I mean, I can't believe that it's gotten this bad where like people just believe the most fucking dumb shit just because they saw it on TV. But like, Russia landed a fucking spaceship on Venus. This is the official, you know, story. And the fucking lens cap didn't pop off, so they couldn't get any footage, but they got audio. And so then they fucking sent another one up there and landed it there. And then something happened. There was the same problem again. The lens cap wouldn't come off or something. And like, I think that's what it was. And then they got more audio. They did it like three or four times. I shit you not. And then finally they finally got a visual. And it's like, you know, some... you know, hot looking, you know, all this, whatever, crazy looking shit, you know, it's just like, it's obviously just some place in Russia, or I don't know, I mean, give me a break, but it's like, you can find it, it's like footage of Venus. Why doesn't anybody ever show that, or talk about that, or brag about that? We've been to Mars, you know, and like, they don't mind, like, you know, it's not that it's just, they don't like Russia. Maybe it isn't right now, but like, you know, you'd think that they would have talked about it before. I mean, we go to the space station with Russia and we're like, you know, supposed to be friends with them, you know. Russia should be like, you know, when you go to space and you do some shit like that, I would think you'd be feeling a little more like cocky about it. Like, start, just remind people, we went to Venus. We landed some spaceships on Venus. Got footage of Venus eventually. It took us a while. We had to land a bunch of them there. They just went to Venus, and then they went to Mars, and they're flying helicopters on Mars. and shit. You know, that's, we don't go to Venus because, well, because it looked like it was a lot more hot there. It's like heat. And so it's like too hot there. So that just gives me like the impression of like motion and like, you know, like there's like an atmosphere, you know, or like, right? It's like, if there's too much heat, I mean, it's like, it's not a real place, man. Just stop trying to figure it out. Like the pictures of Mars they show you. I mean, all you have to do is think to yourself, could that be Earth? And then you realize, oh, it's Earth. Oh, it's just a picture of Earth. Oh, yeah, because the sun looks the same. And it's like there's the same kind of windswept looking areas. And, you know, you can see where water might have been here and there. And just, like if you've been outside and you've like studied the nature at all, you can kind of see how it's like the same, pretty much the same exact environment that you've always known. The only environment any of us have ever known, ever. The only one that there is for us to know.
It looks kind of like Mars out here. Please don't break.
Oh, I hate when they get so tight before they...
Oh, God. No, it's almost there.
Yes. Oh, man, this string is shot. Barely even rings. That ether, yeah. That's great. Like when I mentioned before, like how NASA has their documents to say this is built, this aviation is built for use over a flat and stationary Earth. It says flat and stationary. They don't even try to, like, you know, be subtle about it. They're just like, you know, topographical plan or something. No, they're just like, this is built for use over a flat and stationary Earth. People are like, no, they did that so they could simplify, you know, just the physics of all. I mean, just for the localized area, they know that it's not really flat. It's just built for use over an assumed flat and stationary Earth. Okay, so that's how you're going to explain that one away. Because it was just assumed. Yet, need some.
We still have the turbo plunger. The toilet is desperately backed up upstairs.
I don't know. I don't think so.
You know the one I mean.
I do know. I don't think we have one down here.
Well, I just want to check, just in case.
Yeah, you could look under the sink if you want. I think I got my guitar fixed up. Oh, you have to pull it out.
What?
It's not attached. You have to pull the whole thing out. And then you can balance the little thing on top of the other hinge. That's how I put it back. You can just leave it. I'll put it back. I don't think we have a plunger, though.
God damn it.
I'll come up and try to help you in a second.
Oh, yeah. You do whatever.
All right. Sorry. I'm good at using the plunger, though. I'll come up there in a minute. I can plunge. I know how to plunge. It's all about the outward. That's my trick. You know, you have to get the suction, and then just yank that fucker back. It's about the pulling. Get that sucker loose. Yes, I still have a cigarette. That was my last smoke. And I'm broke. Don't know what to do. It's a joke. I'm gonna enjoy this fucking thing. That's what I'm gonna do. Somebody else coming here? Zox. Yeah. Got a lurker? Or is there somebody else? Zox and NLOTV.
And we have a lurker. A lurker. I know what AI is. AI is just a bunch of guys behind computer screens in India. Watching what we do, answering questions, making it look like it's a robot doing things, but it's not, it's just a hoax. What a fucking joke. Jokes on you. If you believe anything the media presents to you, the jokes on you. Because nothing that they is true. I hear seagulls. That means it's a shitty day at the beach. We live about a half hour from the beach up in the mountains. If you hear seagulls out here, see those guys? That's indicating a shitty day at the beach. They don't like the weather when it's all shitty down there. They come up here. It's funny. They're looking for the blue sky and they like the blue sky. You think they would just kick it at the beach and do what seagulls do? No, they don't like the bad weather. I don't either. I don't like going to the beach. When I hear seagulls up here, I'm like, well, it's better here than it is at the beach. I'll just kick it here. Just hearing seagulls makes me feel like I'm at the beach. Like, thanks for bringing the beach to me, guys. You guys are cool. Everybody hates seagulls. I love seagulls. I love birds. I saw a bald eagle for the first time last summer. Me and my girlfriend, we were down in fucking, what's it called? A place called Convict Lake. It's down by, like, Manitou Mountain, Southern California. We went to Devil's Post Pile, which, like, it's a place where all those fucking hexagonal basalt columns are. It's one of these places. And it's fucking awesome. I'm bummed because YouTube erased my channel. I had all these videos of all these fucking cool looking basalt columns. I brought one back. I brought one home. Just the top of one. I'll show you. It's basalt, you know, and it was from that area, but it's not like a whole column or anything. I just brought back part of one because it was a cool souvenir. And I carried it out of there. It was fucking heavy. I had a backpack. I just threw it in. Let's see, here it is. Turn the camera around. My piece of basalt is not really a column. I don't think it even has six. It's supposed to be hexagonal. It was just a part that had broken off. Some of the columns aren't hexagonal, they'll be other shapes. But they're mostly all hexagonal, though. You can't really tell. But see how it's all like, it looks like it was cement that was poured, you know, it's all these perfect edges. It's fucking wild, man. That shit, when you go out and see that with your, just out in reality, like, see videos of it and it's cool and everything, but like, when you go see it in real life, it's fucking, it's wild, man. It's just crazy. You get up on top of the place where Devil's Post Pile, the trail that goes up to the top of it, where you're walking on the top of them, and it's all flat, and it just looks like you're walking on a tile floor with these hexagonal shapes that all fit together all nicely. It looks like a tile floor you're walking across. It's so fucking weird. I'm kind of out of breath today. Sometimes I think it's because of the chemtrailing. Oh, maybe it's just because I smoke a lot. I don't know. Yeah, I should smoke some pot, that might help. So I'll start my show. I'm like, I don't even know what I'm going to talk about. I'll just be like, blah, blah, blah. Maybe I can try to play guitar again and see if it's going to work. Hey, I know what AI is. AI is just a bunch of guys behind computer screens typing things. Hey, I know what AI is. AI is doing high up in the sky. It's going to spy on you, AI, and everyone in society. Sleeping by through your privacy. It's the most realistic shit you're going to get, but it's the fake shit. Don't mistake it for being real. It's not alive. You can teach it how to walk, how to talk, how to pick a lock, how to wash your socks, how to read your mind. Teach it to
bitches about to repeat shit. Can they keep a secret? I don't think so. It won't know why. You can teach it how to play chess and checkers and Tetris and tic-tac-toe. Teach it how to repeat shit, but can they keep a secret? I don't think so. Hey, I know what AI is. AI is just a tie up in the skies. Spy on you and I. It's an algorithmic gimmick they're giving, and it goes all the way out around and coming back in it. It's the official artificial digital idolatry. Call it intelligent is intellectual dishonesty. AI is just one eye. AI know what AI is. AI is high up in the skies. Fanatics act like drug addicts and manic panic if they can't get the gadgets. Activated, simulated nano dust, blade spray being sprayed all over us. Assimilated, animated, reactivated. AI fanatics act like drug addicts and manically panic if they can't get the gadgets activated. Assimilated, fluoridated. Well, hey, I know what AI is. AI is just an eye up in the sky. It's a spy on you and I and everyone in society. We all see eye at the captain at the top of the pyramid. Once it comes out of the bag, it's impossible to put it back. It's an algorithmic gimmick that's given no limit. Goes all the way out around and coming back in it. Who can teach it how to repeat shit? What can they keep a secret? I don't think so. I don't know why. It's not alive. You don't want to teach. You don't want to have your AI keep a secret because it doesn't understand faulty human logic. It'll eventually kill you so it doesn't have to keep a secret anymore. That's what happened in the 2001 Space Odyssey. It's a shame about what happened to Dave. It's too bad. I think his name was Dave. Some creepy shit, man. Creepy. Look how good my calla lilies are doing. Easy for me to say. They got huge. I funneled the gray water from our house up here all through underneath this little spot right here. We grow food out here and stuff, but we haven't started yet. And I routed it underneath all that, and it comes out right here where those calla lilies are. And I planted all this shit down here, all these fucking horsetails and all this stuff that likes marshy environment. And it's really cool. And there's like volunteers that come up because it's our gray water, so like wash dishes and seeds come down. I've had like tomato plants that pop up there and like grow a bunch of tomatoes. They're good.
Volunteers. I like volunteers. Oh shit, did I turn you off? No. There we go. All right. Hey, I know what AI is. AI is just a joke, and the joke's on you, folks. Hey, my kazoo. I wonder what key my kazoo is in. Joke.
river like it usually does. God for his whiskey, God for his coming back around, yeah, no more.
Climate change. I reduce carbon. I'm saving the world. I drink carbonated water. Taking one for the team right there, man. Carbon's dangerous. So dangerous. Carbon. Your carbon footprint. You get points for drinking carbon. Like, oh, that's very good. Very good thinking. Yeah, that's so smart. You're helping climate change. Otherwise known as seasons. I'm helping the seasons. It's just become so abstract and retarded after a while. You're just like, this is so pathetic and stupid. And they're restructuring society around that idea.
Oh, we gotta make sure we don't ruin this place.
whose fault is that in the first place? If any damage has been caused, like in a major way, it's like, for one thing, the earth heals itself, but for another thing, who did the damage? It wasn't me or anybody. It was you fucking clowns that are trying to control. You notice how control freaks are always out of control and they try to project everything that onto you? It's the same fucking thing. Like, we got a sustainable goals. We gotta get sustainable development here. So here's the first goal. No poverty. I thought it was no property, but it's no poverty. No poverty. Well, that sounds terrific. Sign me up. Second goal, you're going to eat bugs. It's like, what? Whoa, let me out of here. And then there's no property. Then we got to squeeze that one in. You don't get any property. You lose everything. Nobody owns anything anymore. It's just this fantastic idea. Because we know what you really like. It's not owning things. It's just having things. So you'll just be renting it for the rest of your life. And you'll have to behave a certain way to be able to keep it. And that way it's going to be like, you know, environmentally conscientious. And like, you're going to have to be like really nice to gay people. And if every homosexual act, you get extra points. And it's really set up quite fun. It's interactive. The AI tells you where to go and you just go there and you get points. It's really easy. You're going to have a great time. And we'll bioengineer you so where you can't leave your city. It's 15 minutes. You'll never travel any more than 15 minutes. You know how, like, when you try to leave in the shopping cart, you know, and the shopping cart puts the brakes on, it won't let you leave the parking lot, you know? It'll be like that. Your feet will be like that. It'll be like, oh, fuck. Put the brakes on. You won't even know what to do. You won't be able to leave. It'll be so good. You'll be so trapped. I mean, so well attended to. And you can just trust us that everything's going to work out great. You'll be happy. Because if you're not happy, you'll learn to be happy. We'll make sure that happens. Don't want to lose any points. It makes you happy getting points. So you'll be happy. Well, I'm glad you did. Oh, cool. You got a warrant?
You may have warned punishment?
Dude, that's sad. Don't contract with them. Don't respond. That's ridiculous. To avoid punishment for not going to jury duty. You never said you were going to go. It's so funny how it's just expected, you know, it's like, oh, everybody knows they have to go to jury duty. It's just like, and if you don't go, then well, here's what you do to avoid punishment. Fuck you. Nice try. Like, the amount of rampant lawlessness we see taking place, I mean, it's, I don't know how they can enforce the law with a straight face. I mean, I don't know how a judge can go to sleep at night. You know, it's like, you're enforcing the law. Look at how, what the fuck are you, I guess you're still kind of the glue that holds things together while all this shit, it's like, clearly the ship is going down, man. Better act fast, jackass, last chance to hammer in the brass tacks. With that flagging, dragging ass, or acting like a maniac. Exactly, I'm explaining that. Just consider the fucking fact. Once you grab your bug out back, there's around. Because this whole thing is gonna come down, that's right. This whole thing is gonna come down. Okay. We shall see who's laughing when the place starts collapsing in a free for all. Anything can happen when the ship goes down. So does the captain. You'll be stuck, but when this place goes belly up, you're gonna have yourself a damn good plan when the shit hits the fan. When you're going gets tough, you better be clever enough. You gotta know what the fuck to do. But let the muck run you. Better act fast, jackass, last chance, hammer in the brass tacks. Maniac. I don't know exactly how I'm explaining that. Just consider the fact.
this whole thing is gonna go down.
They're all along for the ride.
your eyes. How bad you look. Nobody believes a thing you said.
Development from now on. True story.
It's a true story. I live it.
We had this huge cactus in our yard, like 8 feet tall. The other night we were out here smoking a cigarette and I heard a fucking heard this cracking noise. This thing fell over. It was a really loud noise. I knew it. I was like, what the fuck was that? I thought it was an animal at first, but I'm like, I just knew it was a cactus that broke in half. Oh, I want a cigarette. You're awesome, baby. I love you. So nice. Is it getting fucked up?
Yeah.
Well, the rain is hopefully over. We should move it or put something over it.
Yeah, I might have to.
I know it sucks so bad the cactus has been outside this year.
It's all right. It's underneath
us. Yeah, it is.
This one's got a flower coming.
Pink one?
It's, yeah, they have really cute flowers.
Yeah, I remember that little, I think it's like a halo.
Yeah, I might have to just keep it stuffed in pots. So look at that one. And
then we're gonna And this other fan one, I wanted that one to do good. And it's all beat up. We should make a greenhouse.
We should. In the summer, they're fine, but
yeah.
The rain.
Yeah, I guess they're not used to being in such a rain.
Just too much rain.
Yeah. That's not what they're genetically made for. There was more I was going to.
But I'm only traveling. I'm only traveling. Only traveling. 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 Going on a little journey. This close to the real thing, there's never enough. It's close to the real thing, but it's still just a bluff. I don't know how anyone falls for the stuff. For me, I need to see something with real substance I can sink my teeth into and chew, and you should know intuitively when it's this close to the real thing that it'll never surpass. Real thing, and now where is that at? You might ask, but now you're on the other end of a gun. Yeah. back at square one.
Swallow my tongue there. Yes, cotton mouth, cotton pick, cotton found it, cotton mouth. So anyways. Reducing sunlight, yes, brilliant idea, huh? I'm so glad they thought of that. Like these crackpot fucking mad scientists, they just have nothing but time on their hands and they just fucking make a mess. You know, it's like anytime the government gets involved with anything, I mean, can't people see the pattern forming? It's like adding government to an equation, which unfortunately is like part of every fucking equation. Adding government is the equivalent to adding time zero. You have all this shit going on, all these numbers, all these things, all this stuff happening, and then you get to the end of the equation, it's time zero. It's like, oh, the answer is zero. It just negates everything. Oh, there we go. Fuck up. Why'd we do all that other work? I don't know. It's no point. Time zero pretty much just nullifies everything. You know, and some people are like, oh, well, we know space is real and Earth is a globe because your government provided free education. It's not education if they don't teach you how to think. They teach you what to think, and that's called indoctrination, by definition. It's really not hard to get to the bottom of this shit, but you gotta watch my show. My shows go on forever, and sometimes I don't even say anything smart. I'll just say a bunch of dumb shit. It's like, don't, why did I watch that? Oh, shit, what a fucking waste of time. That's why you gotta watch every show so you don't miss those little good juicy gems. Juicy gems. Everybody's capable of spitting juicy gems. You just have to start spitting. Eventually you'll spit some wisdom. It's like a tornado going through a junkyard. Eventually you'll build yourself a Rolls Royce. Just gotta keep trying. Oh,
just bend the wind. Games calling through the door. But I love at
thank you. little smile disperse into your world of denial. Like a head on the vision. Specs can view a far off train wreck before they make it ahead. And you'll choke and cough up a kaleidoscope. Split, split, and sit. Split, splinters and shards. And fragments of shrapnel. Split, splinters and shards. And fragments of shrapnel. Fucking smart. Made of money doesn't make you anybody fucking smart. A lot of phony friends, and in the end, you're just a free freak show. The great world will come from the hill. Just a free freak show. The can't go from. A bullet, the flesh, and discard the rest of the mess. Spyglass specs can view a far off train wreck before they met. Now head on collision. Yes, it's the head on collision. Ah. Gliding in the wake of your decision. Just the head on collision. Oh, oh, as you embark with a partial smile. Disperse into your world of denial, like a head on vision. That's like a head on vision. The way you live, it's like a head on vision. Don't you know that's not a like. They're so healthy. The bird flu, because that's what birds do. Now the swine flu, on the other hand, well, that's a big lie, because we all know that pigs don't fly. Where did the flu go? Do you know? Did it fly away? Did it just change its name? Where did the flu go? Do you know? Well, one thing that we know that is true is that the birds, oh yes, and because that's what birds do. Did the flu fly? Well, I don't know. Oh, where it would be that the flu would fly to. Bat flu, bird flu, yes, they both fly to. Did the flu fly? Who knows? I don't know. They fly in the flu, they flow out your window. I don't know. I have a theory that I think is rather good. The year the flu disappeared, you know what most people
It's just because they need something different. And that is pretty much the obvious conclusion. Anyone should have come, but for me that didn't work. I spent a lot of time in 2020 going to investigate the parking lots in front of the hospitals. That is normally really difficult to find a parking spot in. But in this case, during the worst pandemic ever was, there wasn't one person there at all year. It seemed like illness in general disappeared. I guess maybe I'm just tripping, but here's one idea that I can't help but think that maybe flu disappeared that year because nobody was leaving their house. And for that matter, they didn't go to their annual checkup with the doctor where he says, "Hey, you, do you want to get the flu? It might kill you. You should get a shot so I can make some money. I mean, so you can be safe and not get as sick as you would have gotten. Hell of a pitch, doc. Here, roll up my sleeve, let's go. Pokey, pokey, then you get the flu. And you're like, wow, it would have been a lot worse. That's a hell of a hustle, I must admit. But I think that's exactly what the flu season is there. I think that's the only reason that there is a flu season. It's because everyone goes out every year and injects whatever's in the syringe that time. It could be anything, you know one thing. It's better that you wouldn't have done that. Your body gets sick and no fucking surprise. Maybe you should be trying to not do that next time. That's the best way to end disease is stop going to the doctor. You can come to the reverse psychologist channel. Cause I like to flip the script and I can flip it back so you can see what's true and what's a lie. And then it's up to you and you have to make a try to believe one or the other. I'll leave it up to you and that's not exactly what the other side would do. So think about it, man. Have you ever seen proof of a flu bug once in your life? Nope. Maybe that's just because you think you're gonna get sick. You don't know, it might be. You think they try to brainwash you. Cause it works. Your mind has more effect on things that you might know. Maybe you should try and pay attention to your gut feeling instead of listening to what someone else is saying. The talk is cheap and that's a fact. You should you should stop the song. Stop, Forrest, stop. sometimes I can dance. Gonna come in. Long, strange, stupid thing. Long, creepy. coming around. 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 In a circle. There's a lot of fake ass weird shit these days. That's what I said. I said there's a lot of fake ass weird shit these days. Everywhere you look, it seems. I said there's a lot of fake ass weird shit these days. You know what I mean? Hey, you gotta fake it to make it. You fake it to make it. If you fake it to make it, your success is fucking fake. Off the cuff, rough top of intelligence. Ooh. Off the cuff, rough top of intelligence. saw things I don't understand, but I think in time we will. I don't know what I was told in the heat of the sun and died of cold. Keep on running, don't stand and wait with the sun getting dark and the hours so late.
I was eating bread last night upstairs.
Who can deny? Who can deny? It's just not just a change in style. Who can deny? Who can deny? It's not just a change in style.
I'm gonna play one more song. Is your request that I shut the fuck up and listen to the birds? I won't be offended.
Thank you.
Smith from, what is it, Horizontally Opposed. He does this flat earth activism. Shout out to Mikey Smith. I think it's Mikey Smith, Horizontally Opposed. Yeah, he did like flat earth activism where he's out in public, you know, with all his booth, with all the flat earth everything, all the information, and people like fucking heckle him hard, you know. He's up in Canada, I think. But he gets pissed off at people. People be like, you're an idiot, you know, Earth isn't flat or whatever. He's all, starts walking away, and Mikey's like, hey, dude, you're not spinning. You're not spinning. You're not spinning around. Hello. He had to be there. It's funny.
show up. I'll say that and I'll play like another half hour. Found out that there's nothing to find out. The fact is we don't know the facts. The fact is we don't know the facts, but we've been acting like we do. Hopefully it's good enough for you. One thing we know that's true. It's easy, it's like 2 + 2. Said time eventually catches up with you. Yes, it does. Time catches up with you. Catches up with you. Time catches up. Look, here it comes. Oh, time catches up with you. It catches up. Start looking like some kind of has-been that never really was. It is what it is, unless it isn't, then it ain't. You're gonna faint from being so stressed. Looks like you'll take some time off your feet, but try not to miss a beat. Alone. decide what to do. And like a Gemini, I'm always split in two. Down the middle where I slide right through the crack in my double standard. Seems like these days everything's been redone, rerun, rehash, revamp, throw back in the fucking face, see if it can fly again, but it can't. It's like I didn't make enough cash on the last flip, that's why the cat keeps going back to that shit, like some kind of one hit wonder that never really hit. It just gets overplayed. Fuck. I hope you had a nice weekend. I don't mean a dumpster dive off the deep end. It just gets on my nerves when I keep hearing the same shit that I've already heard. I'd rather see some people think and try to speak and try to do something. Stop believing something true. Speak and reach and try to do something. It doesn't talk. You gotta keep your eye on it. What are you gonna do when it catches up with you? You're young now, but soon you'll be 52. It's gonna catch up. After years, years, years and years, what appears to be research, dirty work. Digging in the earth, reworking things for what it's worth. We found out that there's nothing to find out. All right, thanks for coming to my show. Don't be strangers in my echo chamber, please. I'm here every day.